Hello students, today we are going to study a new poem, The Big Baboon. Have you seen a monkey? You all must have seen a monkey. You must have visited zoo and seen a monkeys. Monkeys are of various types, isn't it? Chimpanzee, orangutans, these all are types of monkeys that you find. So the big baboon is also a type of monkey that you find in the place in Canada. So if you see the picture, this is a picture of a baboon. You will say that it is not looking like a monkey, but it is different because it found in Canada. So it's a type of monkey having a long face. So I will explain you the chapter line by line. Before that, see the keywords. The first keyword is baboon. Baboon is a large monkey with a long face. Okay, this is a monkey. Plains. What are plains? Plain is a large area of a flat land. Where you find a flat land in a large area, this is called plains. Caribou. Caribou is a place in British Columbia in Canada. So in Canada, this is a place found in Canada. Respectively means in the way the people find acceptable and good. When you well dressed, people likes to talk to you, they respects you, they want to do friendship, so respectively. Whiskers is a long stiff hair on the face of animal. Okay, if you see the animal, that are long hairs are coming out from the cheeks, that are called whiskers. Mr. So-and-so means gentleman. Okay, so let's start the poem and understand the poem line by line. I am reading and explaining. The big baboon is found upon the plains of Caribou. So where does the big baboon found? The poet Hilary Belleck says that the big baboon is found in the plains of Caribou. Caribou is a place found in Canada. So big baboon is found in the Canada. He goes about with nothing on. A shocking thing to do. So have you seen monkey dressing up? Okay, in earlier time, the men used to come with a monkey. They used to play tricks and the monkey used to wear dresses. But usually, the monkey don't wear dress. So this big baboon is also wearing nothing and he is moving here and there. Okay, this is very shocking thing to do. According to the poet says that the big baboon is wearing nothing and moving here and there, which is very shocking thing. But if he dress respectively and let his whiskers grow. But the poet Hilary Belleck says that if he dress respectively, if he dress proper dress, okay, and if dress is neat and clean, iron, shoes is polished, so everybody likes to talk to you, do friendship to you, with you and respects you. So if he dress respectively and whiskers and let his whisker grow. You know, whiskers are hair coming out from the cheeks. Okay, so if he let the whiskers grow, how like this big baboon would be? So how this big baboon will look? It will look very gentleman. The big baboon will look gentleman. So this is a very small poem. I hope everybody has understood. So read the lines and try to understand the poem and see that if any word is difficult, underline it and ask the doubt in the next class. Thank you.